Unbeknownst to you, on Windows 10 or 11, your hard drive may be encrypted with BitLocker even though you didn't activate it. At some future system update, you would be prompted for the BitLocker security key. Without this key, you'd lose access to all your data. Let's make sure you're not surprised like I was. Hello everyone, this is Rick with CyberMedics. BitLocker is Microsoft's drive encryption software that encrypts data on your device in case it is lost or stolen. It may be active on your system without your consent. A single system or BIOS update could make your drive inaccessible without the BitLocker security key. We'll get you prepared so this doesn't happen to you. BitLocker's blue screen of death. When I saw this, I thought I was hacked. Yikes. And the reason is, everything I've read from Microsoft has said that BitLocker is not on the Windows 11 home operating system. Obviously, that is not correct. So how was it activated on my device? This is from Dell. It says it's automatically enabled and the backup recovery key is saved to the Microsoft account. On the same page, Dell says they don't enable BitLocker. I couldn't understand how these two statements both could be true. Doing a little further digging from Microsoft, I found out that they are the ones automatically encrypting the internal drives after you complete the out-of-box experience. The out-of-box experience entails you logging in with a Microsoft account on an HSTI-compliant hardware device. Once you do that, they're going to encrypt your drive and back up your key to your Microsoft account without your consent. Thank you, Microsoft. So the best thing to do is be prepared. First thing to check is, are you logged on with a Windows Microsoft account so that if you get the BitLocker recovery screen, you know what to do. So we'll check that. Come into the Start button and go down to Settings. Here in the search box, type Windows Security and select Windows Security. Click on Account Protection, and if it says you're signed in and you have an email address here, you are signed in with a Microsoft account. Once you've determined whether you're signed in an account, the next thing to do is determine, is BitLocker active on your system? The first method we'll use is the command prompt method. So we'll come down to the Start again. We'll go to Command Prompt, come over and run as an administrator. We'll type in the following command, manage BDE status, and these will be in the description so you can copy and paste them. Once you run that command, it will show you whether BitLocker is on the system and if it's active. And this little helpful statement from Dell, if you lose your key, you will not recover your locked drive. This one below you can see is an external drive that is not encrypted. The next method to determine if it's active on your system is the settings method. So we'll go through the settings, come to Start, click Settings. In Settings, we'll type Device Encryption or ENC4 Encryption. And if that comes up, then you can select it. Here you can turn it off. We're not going to do that. So now that you've determined it is active on your system, what you want to do is recover the key and store it away safely. The first method is to recover the key locally. So we'll click right here under BitLocker Drive Encryption, and it will launch this backup recovery key section in Control Panel. You could have went directly to it in Control Panel also, and you can click on Backup Your Recovery Key. And here you can either save it to a file or print it out. You cannot save it to the BitLocker encrypted drive, because if you can't get access to the drive, you won't be able to get access to the key. So we'll close out of that. And the thing to note on Windows Home is that you have something called BitLocker Lite. At least that's what I call it, because on the Pro version, you have many more options, as well as the ability to encrypt external drives with BitLocker. So the next thing we'll do is recover the key via the web. In this same section, you can find BitLocker recovery key. If you click this, it's going to launch a Microsoft web page. On that web page will be an account link that you can click to recover your key. We're not going to use that method. We're going to close that down. And what we're going to do instead is go to the BitLocker recovery screen and select the link that they had on the screen for recovery. So we'll close this, come into your browser, select the, and then note that this is not a secure link, so there's no security certificate for it. You want to make sure you've typed it in correctly because you cannot tell from the link up here. So continue to the site. And we've secured our Microsoft account with a hardware security key. Click on the link above if you'd like more information. Yubico's security keys make your account practically unhackable, one of the safest ways to protect your account. So next we'll put in our PIN. We'll say OK. We'll physically touch the security key. And then there is your BitLocker security key. Now it's possible you could have a Microsoft account and not have a key backed up to it. And the reason is someone might have set up the system and that key could be backed up to their account. Not a great way to do account security, but that might be the case. If you log in and you don't have the security key, that might be the reason why you don't have it. So the next thing we'll do is we'll get the key locally. So we'll close out of that. Come down here to the start. We'll go to the command prompt and we'll run it as an administrator. We'll type in the following command, manage BDE protectors git c, and it's also in the description of the video. Once you run that command, you will get your security key. The thing to note about this is the ID, recovery ID, is linked with this security key. So you want to store both of these together. Can't do anything with just the ID, but it will let you know that that ID and that key are paired. Next, we'll do a TPM overview and its interaction with BitLocker. When BitLocker is activated on your system, a security key is stored into the TPM module. When you shut your system down, that TPM releases the key and encrypts your drive. When you reboot your system, the TPM releases the key again, unlocks your drive, and allows you to use your computer system. When you shut your system down, the drive will automatically lock. On subsequent reboots, a forensic measurement will be accomplished, measuring the configuration information in the TPM as compared to the actual configuration of your computer system. This configuration information is called a platform configuration register, and all of that information is stored in the memory of the TPM. That configuration state is inextricably tied to the BitLocker security key, and as long as they match, when you boot up your system, it will release the key and unlock your drive. If you decide to update your system or your BIOS, that becomes part of the as-is configuration. And in my particular case, it did not match what was in the TPM. So when I went to go shut the system down, it automatically locked the drive. When I went to reboot it, it did the measurement. It didn't match. It wouldn't release the key. And I wound up with the BitLocker recovery screen. Luckily, I could recover the key from my account. I entered the key. Then it released the key from the TPM, unlocked the drive, and I was able to use my computer system. Next, we'll do a brief overview of the TPM as it is configured and shown into your operating system. We'll come down to the Start menu, go to Device Security, and open that. Here where it says Security Processor, click on that. And here is the information on the TPM module inside the operating system. Next, we'll show you the TPM module as it's configured in the BIOS. I thought it would be a good idea to go into the BIOS and show you what's going on behind the scenes that could cause the BitLocker screen for entering the security key to appear. So what we'll do is scroll over to the security section. And down here, you can see there's firmware TPM is turned on. This is the Trusted Protective Module, which is what holds the security key for BitLocker. And it does something called a trusted measurement of information stored in the computer. And that trusted information is in this secure boot section. Underneath expert key management, you have four categories of information. The first one is the platform key, which establishes a trust between the platform or computer manufacturer and the firmware, in this case, the UEFI BIOS. The next one is the key exchange key database, and that establishes a trust relationship between the firmware and the Windows operating system. Next is the whitelisted database, and it's a set of public keys or digital signatures which is used to execute approved firmware or software. And the last one listed there is the blacklisted database, which is a list of public keys, digital signatures of known malicious, unauthorized firmware or software, a list of bad actors. So getting out of this, what's happening is when the TPM is activated through the boot up process, it will not release the key if anything in those four categories has changed. So that's a summary of what's going on behind the scenes in the BIOS.
This concludes our video demonstration of BitLocker on Windows. Hope you will like the video and consider subscribing to the channel. This supports our efforts in helping others with technology, and have a great and wonderful automation day.